Hi everyone, in this video we are going to see how you can track users based on their IP address in an intranet. So typically if you are using Matomo and that you are on intranet, so I'm gonna give you one example here. Okay, you access to your website, so that's my website. And data will be recorded as the following one. The main issue here is that if you are in an intranet, probably this data based on the Maxmine Azure IP database won't be accurate and won't give you the good location. So in this video we are going to see how we can change that out. So in order to change that out, what you need is a plugin that you'll find if you click over here in admin, and then on the plugin marketplace you can download and install, so I already made it for my website, a plugin named GeoIP Intranet. It has not been developed by the Matomo team, but by a member of the community. I tested it and it works. So Intranet GeoIP, that's the one, Intranet GeoIP. So you activate it, and once you activate it, you have the possibility to modify a file on your server in order to indicate what are the information that you would like to send when a given IP equals something. So in order to access this configuration file, you need of course to access to your server, such as I'm doing right now. So in my case it's this one, okay, Tomo, and then so here you can technically access it through plugins, and then you got it over here, intranet, yups, intranet GeoIP. Okay, and here you get the information. However, you should not modify anything over here, because even if it's written data.example.php here, that's not the file that you should modify in order to have the config correctly. In fact, the file that you need to correct is the one that you find over here in config. And in config, you get the intranet GeoIP data. Okay, so that's a tiny stuff, but you need to know that. Okay. So that's indicated within the documentation of the plugin. Okay, so in fact you need to modify this file in order to say, okay, when I'm gonna see next time this given IP address, what should I do? And this given IP address is of course the one that I was showing you before. So what I'm gonna do is that I'm gonna change the different conditions for this IP address, so this one, and I'm gonna give it actually an exact latitude and longitude, because that's typically what you can do with Matomo. And the idea is to give actually the information about this given office, the one that you can see over here, in order to show you that we can go very far in the tracking of a given user on the internet. So I'm gonna put this, I'm gonna put longitude as this. Okay, so in fact it corresponds to Dublin, the city of Dublin, so I'm gonna put Dublin here. I'm gonna precise that it's office 234 off, and I can even precise the name and first name of the pair. Of course that's not good for privacy, but the idea is actually to show you that it exists. Location country, it's Ireland here, but I don't know by heart, so I hope it's IE, not sure, let's double check it. Yep, okay, Ireland, it seems like it's IE. Okay, so I'm gonna go this way. And so location region, I don't know this one. This one I should double check it at the link that they put over here, because here I guess they're gonna put me in Austria, which is not good, but never mind. And here put whatever I want. I can, that's the telecommunication provider. Okay, and that's all that you need. In fact, if it cannot find out the location, it will take those data. I mean, if the condition doesn't match the one which is over here, so this given IP address, it will take this one. So in my case, pretty sure that it's gonna take it. Just to let you know that once you install, once you modify this file, get it run the first time, you need to uncomment it because by default it's commented, so it's not gonna work. But once you uncomment it, so here and here, you will make your file a working file. So normally now, next time I'm logged in my Matomo, it's gonna say that I'm located in Dublin at office 234 and with my first name and family name, and it will indicate as well the exact location with latitude and longitude. And here I should modify this one, but it's gonna take me a while in order to find out what is the location region. So you save your file, so this is what I just did over here, and I'm gonna now connect back to my website. So okay, I'm just gonna click on this given link, and normally I should appear as someone who is coming from this country. So here doesn't work, as you can see. Probably that's because oh, maybe I need to activate it. Did I activate it? Internet. Yes, I activated it. So what I'm gonna do is that I'm just gonna delete my visit in order to appear as a new visitor. So that's what I'm gonna do right now. I'm gonna just delete my visit. Okay. Delete my visit. Yes. Okay, great. And now I guess that if I connect back to my website like this, I will be considered as a new visitor. Okay. Okay, and as you can see now, this given IP address is considered as being located in Dublin in office 234. This is the office of myself. This is the provider. And I even get, so as you can see, the latitude and longitude, which correspond exactly to this given office. So you know that the location is really accurate, as you own, of course, your own database when you are on the internet. So can be, of course, pretty intrusive, but you have to consider that on the internet it's another company or organization, so the rules may be different in terms of privacy according to the contract which have been signed up. So about the location, as you can see, the region is not going to be accurate because I did not pick up the right value, so I just should investigate in order to find out what is the region location here for Dublin. And for the rest, all is fine. So of course, this information will be a bit biased because it's not Dublin anymore. It's Dublin office 234, but with a filter, you can get it fine. Just get the information, Dublin. So hope you enjoyed this video and hope it will give you nice ideas about how you can track people with IP address on the internet. Thanks for watching.